But publication bias is a serious infrastructural problem. This is a great example of it. This is a funnel plot, which is, again, another nerdy thing from systematic reviews. And this is glucosamine for osteoarthritis. And this always interests me because back in the day, years ago, when I had a rugby injury, I started taking glucosamine because the evidence looked kind of promising, right? I don't take it now. So this is a systematic review of glucosamine trials. And what you'll see here is the effect size is reflected down the bottom in units of standard deviation. So what we want to see is negative numbers because that means less pain, okay? And this dashed line here represents the average effect across all the trials they found of glucosamine versus placebo. So what we would expect to see if there's no publication bias is the big trials, which are really precise, cluster really close to that average treatment effect. And as the trials get smaller, because small trials are very imprecise, they're going to spread out either side of the effect in a kind of funnel. But what we often see is one side of the funnel goes missing, right? So these empty spaces here should have a bunch of blobs just like this one, but they don't. And what that implies, it's not absolute proof, but it is a hint, it is exploratory evidence that there is publication bias going on here. Because the big trials are getting published and the small negative trials aren't. But the small trials that really punch an effect size, they're making it into print. What's even more interesting about this is, you see the red squares, they're all trials from one manufacturer, which is Rotapharm. And the red diamonds, they're everyone else. Can you see a thing here? Because they're all testing the same compound, right? Look at that. This is the most extreme funnel plot I've ever seen. And what it shows you is small trials of Rotapharm that are really effective, show that it's really effective, are over here. They're getting published. But there's a big gap over here, and it's specific to one manufacturer. Now, this systematic review said that most of the heterogeneity in glucosamine trials is explained by brand. Trials using the Rotapharm Madhouse product have a superior outcome. But that systematically fails to acknowledge that we can explain that because small studies that don't show an effect aren't getting published. This average here is derived from all these trials. So if we threw in three or four on the other side of the funnel, how effective do you think glucosamine would be compared to placebo? Not at all, not at all. So publication bias is something to be aware of.